So we have it being recorded. I'm going to check to see if Brother Captain Dennis is ready, and we'll be starting soon. Thank you all once again, brothers and sisters. Brother Dennis will be coming on in the next minute. Assalamu alaikum. Can you hear me, Brother Willie?
Yes, sir, I can hear you, my brother. So we're on okay. And we're waiting.
Okay, thank you so much. First and foremost, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Most Merciful, giving honor and praise to Almighty God Allah for giving me another chance that I may be able to correct yesterday's mistake. We forever thank him for all of his service and profits that he has given us, and I will forever be grateful for the man that he had brought into my life, and that's the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, the Exalted Christ and Minister Farrakhan, who we see as God's representative in our midst today. I'd like to thank each and every one of you who took time out of your busy schedule to join us on the series, Muhammad Makes Champions. We were very honored that this was brought to my attention or the brainchild of Brother Student Minister Willie out of New Orleans, who felt that my contribution in the areas of motivation and inspiration is most certainly could be used to inspire men and women in the nation and outside the nation who are striving very hard in their prospective positions of leadership. So we chose the title champion. And out of the title champion, God has blessed us to take each and every letter in the word champion and break down the letter to a principle, the 8 principles that makes a champion. And God has blessed us to break down the letter C to represent confident. And then we went to the letter H that represented heart. And then the letter A, we broke down the word adversity. And then the letter M, we broke down the word motive, motivation. And then we broke down the word last week, P, which represents persistent, persistent. And now today we are going to the letter I. And the letter I for this particular principle stands for initiative. Initiative. Initiative means, in the definition, taking the first step or making the first move. I think one of the greatest contributions as a person in leadership or a champion is that we must take the first step. This principle could be found in our lesson in General Orders as the Fruit of Islam. We're taught General Order number 1. And General Order number 1, as I state, is to take charge of this post or my post and all temple property in view. The very key word is to take charge, not to wait, not to have someone tell you, but the word to take charge is an aggressive action. It's not a passive action. It is an aggressive action. And that's the way you must be in order that we may be successful in being a champion. We must make the first move. We must initiate the first step. We must also recognize that when we represent or act on the initiative, that is taking the first step, and that is aggressive action, and that is the action that most of the time makes one a champion. When I started my Peacekeepers movement, I did not want it to be called an organization. I want it to be called an initiative. An initiative. It's called the Peacekeepers Global Initiative, meaning that we are taking the first step. We are beginning to take charge of what? We're taking charge of our community. We're taking charge of being able to guide our young people into better behavior. We are no longer waiting on someone to tell us what to do. We take the initiative. We take the first step to go after our young people and to save them. We take the first step or go after our youth and be able to guide them to a better way of life. We take the first step, the first action, the initiative to clean up and make our community a safe and decent place to live. So one of the great principles of a champion, this has been the hallmark of the training of those of us in the Nation of Islam. You want to know why, when you see the Muslims under the leadership of Minister Farrakhan, why we act the way we act? We are taught to take charge. When you see any member of the Nation of Islam or the Fruit of Islam, there's something that we go to do. We just take over. Take charge not only means to take charge, but it also means we take over. We are very dominant. When you find us, we're not a passive organization. We are very aggressive in the manner of being able to implement the laws, the policies, and the procedures. We are aggressive in fighting crime. We are aggressive in fighting ignorance. We are aggressive in bringing our community in a state of order and peace. If there's any time that we don't mind being the aggressor, that is the time that we are the aggressor. For the Holy Quran said Allah hates the aggressor. Well, we hate that aggressor who fight with those who don't fight with them first. We are taught to not to be that kind of aggressor, that we aggress upon a human being in a very violent way. No, 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 sir. No, ma'am. Not that kind of aggressor. But there's nothing wrong with being aggressive as it relates to the goals that we're going after in life. When you go into the community, you're looking at very hard-hearted young people who, when you look at their face, you see the world in their eyes. Why are our young people so hard? Why are they so aggressive and so violent? Well, look at the condition in which they come out of. Look at our community. Our community is the same kind of atmosphere and environment that you would find in a jungle. It is the same environment that you would find in a hostile wilderness. So when you look at our young people, they can't come out of the home with a very passive look. They can't come out the home with a very humble look. The humble and passive behavior can be done in the mosque. You can have a humble behavior in the mosque because people respect humbleness in the mosque. But you can't bring a humble attitude in an aggressive, violent environment. You and I must understand that when we're talking about taking charge, you and I have to understand that we can no longer depend on law enforcement to clean up our communities. I was blessed yesterday, New Year's Day, the first day of 2014. I did not waste no time, not one day, to get at the business of hand. I didn't want it to get started today, 2014, January the 2nd. We assembled some men yesterday, January the 1st, 2014, and we discussed about carving up the city of Columbus, taking charge of the city of Columbus, no longer dependent on law enforcement to bring some sense of peace and harmony in our community because they have failed. Columbus closed out with over 3 homicides New Year's Eve. It is traditional in Ohio or Columbus to bring in New Year's with firing off your gun in the air. Some cities, some states, that's not permissible. But it is a tradition that ever since I was a kid, it is a known fact you take your shotgun or your little gun and you go, and soon as the clock hits 12, you fire off your rounds. But this particular year, they didn't wait to 12 o'clock. You heard gunfire at 11 o'clock. Then it's normally after 12, 12.05, the gunfire desists. You don't hear no more normally. But you know you always got to be wary and concerned about that one who fell asleep, wake up late, and still want to pop off a few rounds around 12.10, 12.15. But this year, It started early. This year, they was popping off rounds all the way to 12:30, 12:45, 1 o'clock. You were thinking they were celebrating the New Year's coming in on the West Coast. 3 killings took place as people brought in the New Year. As they was bringing in the New Year, 3 homicides. So 3 people did not see 2014. Or if they seen it, they seen 2014 a minute after 2014. Well, what are we saying? We're saying, are we looking for law enforcement to make our community safe? We say, we wish you a happy new year. Look at the words. We wish you a happy new year. How could you have a happy new year unless you don't repeat the sadness of last year? I'm sure somebody told us in 2013, happy new year. But was it a happy new year? You tell me, did you have a happy new year in 2013? Surely somebody told you in 2013, happy new year's, Brother Minister Willie. Happy new year's, Brother Dennis, in 2000. Well, was it a happy new year? How could I say it was a happy new year when I'm coming into 2014 with less family members? How can I say it's a happy new year with less friends? Some have been taken out by gun violence, either directly or indirectly. So in order that we may guarantee that 2014 will be a happy new year, we have to be in agreement that we're going to make sure that we won't repeat the sadness of last year. So we assembled some men. We sent out a call on Facebook to all the men in Columbus who are concerned about, let's get started now. Let's take the initiative. Let's take the initiative. Let's take the initiative. Let's make the first step on 2014, January the 1st, to say, this is the beginning of forever. Today, 2014, January the 1st, is the beginning of forever. What do you mean, Brother Dennis, it's the beginning of forever? It is the beginning that we men who assembled in this room have made a pledge that from this day forward, we would never stop making our community straight, safe. This day forward, we would never stop and be present for peace. This day forward, until we eradicate drugs and violence out of our community, if it takes 100 years, this day forward, we would never go backwards, but we would go forward. This day is the first day of forever in Columbus, Ohio, that would carve up that community, and we would take charge of our posts and all temple properties in view. Well, when we say in the nation the temple property in view, then we're really saying all of God's property. Well, we're not talking about no buildings. Property don't mean buildings. When we were in slavery, we were the property of Mr. Jones, Mr. Smith. So you have property can be assigned to cattle. Property could be assigned to buildings. Property could be assigned to land, but property can also be assigned to human beings. So we are taking charge of God's property, meaning we take a charge of God's people. And everything was in our reach. And in our view, we are accepting the responsibility as men. So yesterday, we took the initiative. We took the first step. You can't wait at home, family. You want to lose weight. That's your New Year's resolution. Then take the initiative. Take the first step. Make the first move. Start the first action towards it, because there's no one who's better at getting you to go after your goals and love your goals better than you. No one is more desirable to see that weight come off, more desirable than you. No one is more desirable to see you get out of a bad relationship than you. No one is more desirable than obtaining that degree than you. No one is more desirable than trying to clean up your life and find your way to God and give up this wicked world and the wicked ways of this world. No one is more desirable to do that than you. And you must take the first step. You must take the initiative. You must take charge of your life. We have a lesson that says, will you wait at home for a mystery God to bring you food? Our answer is emphatically no. What do you mean, will you wait at home for a mystery God? Some of us thinking that procrastination will get us what we want, but everybody knows procrastination does not lead to nothing. We have to understand that we must take the initiative. So you must have what we call the God attitude. Well, what is the God attitude? If I don't do it, it will not get done. If I don't do it, it will not get done. Dishes is in the sink. If I don't clean those dishes, those dishes won't get clean. Food need to be put on the table. If I don't go out here and get a job to put food on that table, ain't no food gonna get on that table. We have to take the initiative. Make the first move. Take the first step. That's how it begins. Procrastination is the enemy of success. And we must not procrastinate. We must be able to recognize. Just like we recognize that you better, it's best to be proactive than to be reactive. Well, what do you mean? What do we mean it's better to be proactive than to be reactive? I said to the men yesterday, our very present 20, 30, 50, 100 men in an orange shirt, our very present, listen to this, our very present is a deterrent to crime and violence. Our only plan, our only purpose is to take men out there after the school let out at 2:45 when our children come out to school and look out and see a sea of orange, see men standing out there as a deterrent. And then I ask the brothers, break down the definition of the word deterrent. And one of the key words in the word deterrent is discourage. So we said to the brothers yesterday, our purpose of being present is to discourage them. Redirect them from committing any acts of violence and crime in our presence. A young man brought his two children. He couldn't find no one to watch his two children to be at the meeting, so he brought them with him. And as they were there, and I was talking to these men, I pointed to these two children. I said, as long as Pop's present, these two children would not act up. As long as Pop's present, these children would not be bad or do things that would get them a behind whooping. Am I right? Everybody nod their head. But as soon as Pops is out of their view, as soon as Pops is absent, everything that we ever did that was wrong when we was children. We didn't do it in the presence of our parents. We did it in the absence of our parents. So what we said to the men yesterday, that our presence becomes a deterrent, a discouragement for our young people to commit any acts of violence. And that's how simple we can solve the problems in our community. Now, that don't mean it solved the problems of employment, education. I don't mean just standing out there to guarantee our children would not act a fool while they get out of school would stop them, that would give them jobs, that would give them stop teenage pregnancy, that would stop alcohol and drugs. We're not saying that because that's social work. And we're not social workers. We're peacekeepers. We're only out there to stabilize our community and deter our kids from crime and violence until social organizations or social agencies that deal with alcohol and drug abuse and social agencies that deal with mentorship, social agencies that deal with jobs and job training, social agencies that deal with education and GEDs, until social agencies deal with poverty, until social agencies deal with reentry programs, until social agencies deal with homelessness. When all those social agencies come together to address the social problems that create crime and violence, it's only then. And we can live in a peaceful, respectful community, because everywhere you will find crime and violence, I guarantee you, family, you will find unmet social needs. So it's better to be proactive than reactive. So we, the peacekeepers, proactive means initiative. Proactive means to be pro, meaning before, be out there, be first. So as a champion, you and I must take the initiative. You want to get anything in life? Even God makes us take the first step towards Him. Isn't that wonderful? God don't come to us. No, no. You and I have to go to God willingly. He makes us. So the Bible said, or we are taught as Muslims, you take the first step towards God, and God takes the second and third towards you. But you got to take the initiative first. You must act first. You must make the first move towards God. And God would make the second and the third towards you. That is such a wonderful principle. That's what makes a champion a champion. They take the initiative. They take the first step. So I thank you, those of you who have come on today, for giving me your ear and your time. We want you to know that there's a storm coming, nothing like they've seen. They said over 100 million people will be affected by this storm. We're living in some very unusual time. Minister Farrakhan last Saturday, and you need to tune in to Minister Farrakhan this Saturday on the time and what must be done. He spoke about what they call UFOs, which is unidentified flying objects. We don't call them UFOs because they are identified. They're not unidentified. We'll call them, he talked about the mother plane and the baby planes that we see. And we've been preaching this for over 80 years. And everybody now began to believe what Minister Farrakhan said, that he was taken up on the mother plane in a vision. And just to show you how timely what he said now, today, last night, they said they seen New Year's Eve. They seen all of these lights, and there's been people that seen them in California. Oh, now I know what lights look like. This thing paused, blinked, moved quick, then took off at a high rate of speed. And then after that, a couple weeks ago, last week, they seen one shooting across the sky. Now, why all of a sudden the minister talks about this, and now it's all being seen? But look what the minister says, the mother plane, the baby planes, God's calling card. Ooh. Well, when somebody leaves your calling card, you know what a calling card is. So if that's God's calling card, then what is God telling us? Because clearly we've just been seeing them last night, yesterday, the day before. They're crisscrossing throughout the whole world in America, and you would see more of this. What is this telling us? What time are we living in? Are we really living in at the end of the world? I know you didn't call to hear this. But I have to be honest. This is what makes champions. Muhammad makes champions. In order to make champions, you have to give champions a champion trainer. And it's been this kind of teachings and training that have made Brother Dennis the man that I am. I may be one man, dear family, but God blessed me to take the initiative to start the Peacekeepers. And I remember going to New Orleans and starting my first chapter with Brother Student Minister Willie. And he remembered when there was only one chapter. Brother Dennis took the initiative. And now we got 21 chapters and it's constantly growing. From one man who was built as a champion or made as a champion for Mr. Muhammad. So I cannot ignore the training of the Nation of Islam, because some may have a problem with my leading teacher, the Honorable Minister Farrakhan. I'm going to deny my training and what made me the man I am. What kind of fool you think I would be? I hope through my example of having peacekeepers that are Christian. I hope through my example they're having peacekeepers who are Muslims. I hope through my example who have peacekeepers who are white. Yes, who are white. I hope through my example have a peacekeepers who are Jews. Yes, I said it. We have Jewish peacekeepers. I hope through my example to have peacekeepers from every persuasion that through this example that you can look at me and know that my leader, Minister Farrakhan, is not none of that they had ascribed to him. I hope through my example that man taught and trained me, because the scripture says these words, a tree is known by the fruit it bears. I am the fruit of Islam. And I'm bred from a tree called Mr. Muhammad, the Nation of Islam. I am the fruit of that teaching. And if you see me grow into the man that God has taken me into, and I'm transcending religion, I'm transcending politics, I'm transcending race. Well, what is that saying? Because in our lesson, the last stage, the last Muslim wants, Muslim believes on the point number 12. Father, and lastly, there's no God but Allah, and He will establish a universal of peace where we all can live in peace. Wow. He will establish a universal government of peace where we all, not where we all just black folks, where we all human beings, all human beings, all human beings can live in peace. And here we have an initiative called the Peacekeepers. Well, I hope and pray that God is using me as one of those bricks to build that great kingdom. I'm just one brick out of the millions that God's going to use to build His kingdom. I hope that you a brick too, that you would be a brick that God would use to build that wonderful kingdom of peace, not in heaven, but right here on earth. And that means in order for us to establish peace, he must get rid of the peace breaker. So I thank you. I hope I haven't offended no one, but I have to speak the truth because I believe that is only the truth that shall set us free. I thank you. That was I. Initiative. You must take the initiative, the first step towards any of your goals in life. And so the next letter that I'm excited about, that we're going to talk about, is the letter O. All right, so next week, we're going to break down the letter O and the letter champion. And I was just thinking about, man, that word O, it just caused me to pause for a minute, excuse me, but I was just thinking about how excited I am to break down the letter O. But next Thursday, God willing, 7:30, same time, and we would go into the letter O and break down the principle of the letter O. And let me say this. I thank you, those of you who get off the air, after you get off, you hit me up on Facebook, you hit me up on Twitter, you tell me how encouraging the word is. Thank you so much. We do have a playback. We normally, after next day, Brother Minister Willie will put the playback. So not only can you listen to what I say, but you can have other people to listen who may miss it. But I love your feedback. Please share with me if you enjoyed what we have to say. Anything that you would like to share with me, I'd be so honored to hear from you. Let me know. Just say thank you. Just say thank you. That kind of let me know, the listening audience, how well we are doing. But I thank you so much for taking time out your schedule. Thank you, Brother Student Minister Willie. And the playback will be on Facebook tomorrow. May God bless each and every one of you. My name is Brother Dennis Muhammad, and I am present for peace. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaykum salam, Brother Dennis. And we thank you all, brothers and sisters who made on this call. We pray that you got something, as I know I did, from letter I, dealing with initiative. So let's take this principle, implement it in the great work that each of you all are doing in the community. Keep it up, brothers. Keep it up, sisters. Implement it in your personal life. And as Brother Dennis said, go on Facebook and send him an email, whatever, what you liked about it, what you didn't like. Let's be honest. We're all brothers and we're all family, and it's all for our own benefit. But thank you all, brothers and sisters, and keep doing the work that's making each of you champions. Good night.